people's favorite galaxy is our own. But the Milky Way is just scratching the surface of the galaxy genre. Our next guest studies galaxies beyond our own, and she knows some of the indie galaxies that you haven't even heard of yet.
The Milky Way. With 100 billion glittering stars, it's the galaxy we call home. It's so vast that to travel from one end to the other, it would take 100,000 years at the speed of light. You can cross that trip off your bucket list. Lucky for us, Dr. Burcin Mutlu-Pakdil is exploring the universe from right here on Earth, and she's going to tell me all about it.
So my interest to science started with a homework assignment about black holes, because these systems are super interesting. They time travel. It is super cool. So I was super interested in black holes first.
Talk about reaching for the stars. To learn more, I'm heading to a Chicago rooftop where it will be easier to see them once it gets dark.
Hi, Dr. Burcin. Wow, this is an amazing view. Welcome to Chicago.
Thank you so much. I see why it is the Windy City. It's so gorgeous, though. So you're an astrophysicist. What does that mean, and what do you get to do?
So as an astrophysicist, I study galaxies. And I take images from cool big telescopes all around the world and try to understand our place in the universe.
Wow, galaxies, that's so cool. You really are out of this world then, aren't you?
Dr. Burcin is also all over the world too, using super powerful telescopes from Chile to Hawaii, even the Hubble Space Telescope. She scans the images of space for unusual objects or new galaxies.
What even makes a galaxy?
Good question. Actually, to understand that, maybe we should just build one ourselves.
Once it's dark enough to see the stars, or the string lights in the case of our model, we start to build our galaxy, the Milky Way. Galaxies are made of stars, planets, space dust, gas, and black holes, which lie at the center of most galaxies. In these extremely dense and compact regions of space, the gravity is so strong that nothing can escape, not even light.
So do I have to worry about falling into a black hole?
Don't worry, we are far from it.
Okay, that's good to know.
Typically, galaxies are one of four types: spiral, elliptical, disk, or irregular. The Milky Way is a spiral galaxy with long curved arms.
They mostly have blue stars, which are young stars.
Then we add the galaxy's billions of planets, moons, and asteroids.
Where would you say that we are?
So we are not at the center of galaxy. We are about just middle of a spiral arm.
Next, glitter represents cosmic dust. And we can't forget to add interstellar gas, which occupies the space in between stars.
Ah, oh, that is so cool. You can see all the gas and the dust and the stars.
This gas is 90% hydrogen and 10% helium, with a mass equal to about 15% of all the stars in the galaxy.
So you have to look through all of this stuff when you're searching for new galaxies.
Yes, that's exactly.
When the image of a new star is contaminated by the light from other stars, Dr. Burcin is able to use advanced algorithms to remove the contamination from the image.
Have you found anything interesting?
Actually, we did. We find an extremely rare galaxy, and now it's commonly referred to as Burcin's galaxy.
You discovered a galaxy and named it after yourself.
That's correct.
That has got to be the coolest thing ever.
Burcin's galaxy is 359 million light years away, but there's a model of it right here. It features a central elliptical galaxy with two symmetrical rings of stars, one young, one old.
There's no other example of galaxies like this.
That is amazing.
So since this is a very peculiar galaxy, very unique object, it belongs a totally different category. We call them peculiar galaxies.
So how does it feel having discovered a new galaxy?
It's actually pretty cool. It feels good, and it actually keeps me more motivated to learn for more stuff, because I know there are more objects like this one waiting to be discovered in space.
That is, I mean, that's fantastic. My mind is so blown. I am so inspired by you, and you're pushing the boundaries of the universe by the work that you do. Thank you so much, Dr. Burcin. I feel like I've met a real life star.
Oh, you are so kind. Thank you.
And if you ever need anyone to make another galaxy with, you know who to call.
Bye.